All right. This is a question about
Secretary, because the data showed that in the 5 years that the president has been in power, 61 lawyers, judges, and prosecutors were killed. And this is a big number compared to 49 killings over 44 years from the Marcos time to Aquino. So can we just get your reaction to these big figures?
Alam mo yung trabaho ng mga lawyers, alam naman nila yan from the beginning that their profession is fraught with danger, no? So I am not in a position to say siya na may kinalaman kung sino ang presidente, no? Doon sa number ng mga namamatay na abogado o fiscal o judges, no? Kasi in the exercise of their profession, many lawyers, no? Are representing clients even before who are involved in very controversial cases. May mga drug cases, may anti-terrorism, may mga terrorism cases, corruption cases, election cases. So, yung mga ganong klaseng, yung nature ng mga cases na hinahawakan nila really exposes lawyers to some personal risk or safety, you know, or issues of security. Nangyayari talaga yan. And apart from mga other causes na common also to other professionals, maaaring ang reason for the violence committed against them ay personal, maaaring business-related, maaaring political, and so forth and so on. Kaya, or maybe may mga certain advocacy sila, no, na personal or, na pinaprosecute or pinapursue very actively. So, maraming possible causes kung bakit nagkakaroon ng death among members of the legal profession. So parang it's so difficult for me to relate yung number of deaths and make a comparison depende kung sino ang presidente ng Pilipinas. Well, the president himself is a lawyer. Pia, do you think he will have a policy na parang, will be something that will put his fellow members of the legal profession in personal jeopardy or something to that effect? I don't think so. Nangyayari yan because of circumstances prevailing and not because of whoever is the head of the present administration.